Hey friends, welcome back to another How to Study video. My name is Conor Diblin, and in this video I'm going to be talking to you about the most effective and probably the most fun way to learn absolutely anything. We're going to be exploring just what this technique is, why it is so damn effective, and how you can include it in your revision. Remember to watch right to the end and to subscribe for more. Just one more thing before we jump in. Scroll down, smash that like button, scroll back up, carry on watching. The study technique that I'm talking about is, of course, active recall. Active recall is the act of extracting facts or knowledge from your brain while you're revising. This is in contrast to other types of learning where you're trying to force information in. Active recall is trying to get information out, and in doing so, you're cementing that knowledge in place within your brain. It is firing up those neurons, forcing them to remember the content that they are wired up to, and it is the fastest way to remember anything. Studying using active recall is just ridiculously powerful. Over the course of just 1 week, in studies, students have been shown that by using active recall, rather than not using active recall, they can remember 8 times as much. Eight times better. Is there a single student out there who wouldn't like to do 8 times better than their peers? Why does active recall, and in essence what active recall is, which is practice testing, improve your memory? There's been a huge wealth of studies showing that active recall works, but the evidence required to explain why has been lagging behind a little bit. That being said, in recent years, we have come up with a couple different explanations for why that might be, and I think they go hand in hand pretty nicely. That is the direct effects and the mediated effects of active recall. First of all, testing can enhance your learning process by triggering the elaborative retrieval process. Attempting to retrieve very targeted information from deep within your long-term memory can hardwire those pathways. It also activates related information, so information that you learn around the same time or in the same way as the information you're trying to retrieve. So that means by doing a practice question, you're actually going to be remembering more than just what that practice question is asking. This activated memory, this activated information that you're remembering on top of what you're trying to remember, is then encoded alongside it even harder. In encoding this kind of peripheral information along with the information you're trying to remember, what you're doing is you're creating new and kind of indirect pathways to that piece of information. What that means is there are now multiple connections between multiple parts of your memory and that piece of information. These multiple pathways then better facilitate access to that information at a later date, such as your real exam. This would be one of the mediated effects of active recall. So that is that by remembering something, you're encoding new pathways to that information and to other pieces of relevant information. The direct benefits are fairly obvious, I think. That is that you are retrieving information and you are training your brain to be able to access that piece of information. Every time you access the information, your neurons are firing in a particular way, and you are encoding that again. Active recall is, as the name suggests, an active process, and that's why it's so good for learning. Learning needs to be an active process rather than a passive process. Now, the passive processes of learning would be things like someone reading out some information to you, you just passively reading some text and not interacting with it at all, or maybe even you going through your text and highlighting parts. The active part is where you try and retrieve that knowledge from within that vast scaffold of information that makes up our brain. What's important here is that you need to use active recall on everything you're trying to learn. So not just the things that you already feel like you've mastered. So you just sat in your biology class and you've learned about cells, for example. If you feel like you already know what a mitochondria is, but you don't know what a ribosome, you still need to practice both. That is still vital information that you're trying to learn, and you need to actively be recalling all of it. So how can you incorporate active recall into your studying and your revision? Well, as I've said, to be active in your active recall, you need to be active in your practice. For your recall to be active, you need to be actively trying to recall the information. And what that means is testing yourself. However, what type of questions should you use here? Generally, exams, especially in medical school, fall into two camps. You either have multiple choice exams, where you're given a stem of a question and then several options for your answer. And this is in contrast to kind of open questions, whereby you're given a question and a blank text box where you need to put the information in yourself. Now, for this to be an active process, I think you need to be doing the latter of these. In a multiple choice question, the information you're trying to retrieve is already on the page. Multiple choice questions are a great way of learning information, but they're not an active recall process. What a multiple choice question is doing is it is training you to recognize an answer, not remember it. Granted, you are learning to find the right answer from within a list of options, but you're not training yourself to already know the correct answer. So we want to be using questions that do not have answers with them, even if you're practicing for a multiple choice exam. So all of my exams are multiple choice, and multiple choice exams and multiple choice training does make up a part of my revision. But if I'm trying to remember something and learn something, I need to be practicing without the options there. So you have an option here. Either you can create your own questions from your lecture notes and that sort of thing, or you can go off and you can find questions to practice. Now, it's much easier to find multiple choice questions, especially for medicine. I take that multiple choice question and I remove the options. And so I need to just learn how to answer that question. What I like to do, rather than passively reviewing lecture notes and just highlighting things, is I like to take a look at the information and write out questions which I'll be able to answer later on. If I've just had a lecture about dealing with an acute asthma attack in pediatrics, rather than highlighting the different parts of it, I will say to myself, what are the key differential factors between a moderate and a severe asthma attack in children? And I'll have to answer that question. What about if you're not studying something like medicine where there are clear-cut questions? How else can you include active recall in your practice? To do this, I would recommend the SQ3R method. The SQ3R method will help you to remember anything. So this could be remembering a chapter from your history textbook. It might be remembering an essay that you've seen and then you have to recreate in your exam. Or it might be remembering a section of a medical textbook. The method has 5 sections in order, and they are to survey, to question, to read, to retrieve, and to review. And we're going to go through what each of those means. In the survey section, you're going to be surveying the information. What that means is you're going to skim through the text that's in front of you and work out what it's about. Section 2 is the question method. Now that you've read through the text and you've skimmed over and you've worked out the general idea of what information is within this text, you're going to write out some questions that you have about the text and questions that the text is going to answer. Your third task here is you're going to actively read the text and try and work out what the answers to those questions would be. So rather than just reading the text for information and trying to remember it, you've already written out some questions and you're trying to find answers to these questions in the text. The fourth part of this method is the active recall part. This is where you're going to actively try and answer those questions that you wrote out for the second part using information that you've remembered from when you read through the text. Here you want to rephrase the text into your own words and try and answer those questions. You have the option here of either doing it orally, so out loud, maybe not if you're in the library though, or you can do it in writing. Once you've finished retrieving the information and answering those questions that you wrote out originally, now you're going to review your answers to those questions and you need to kind of summarize what this text is about and what you've learned from it. I like to use this method when I'm going over my revision notes. So any notes that I wrote in my first few years of medical school, when I wrote very extensive long notes during my lectures, I can look over paragraphs of what I've written. I can try and summarize, write some questions. I'll quickly read the text and try and answer those questions. Then I try and answer those questions in my own words. And then I'll review what I've said and whether that's correct, and I'll correct anything that I got wrong. And then I'll try and summarize the text very briefly. Now, when you want to go back to that text, you already have those questions written. And when you're going to try and review it for the second time or the third time, you want to start at the retrieval section. So you start off by retrieving the answers to those questions from your memory. Answer as many of the questions as you can. Have a review of the questions that you answered and anything that you didn't answer. And if there's anything that you had no idea about the answer for the first time, try and answer those ones again. Review again. Now remember, active recall needs to be used in combination with the other revision techniques that we've spoken about on this channel before. So repetition is still key here. In order to remember something, you need to repeat it. And the active recall is part of that repetition, but you're also going to need to be actively recalling information a number of times before it sticks. I really hope you found this video informative and hopefully interesting. And let me know in the comments below if you're going to be using the SQ3R method in your revision. If you have anything that you'd like me to cover, or you have any revision techniques for me that I need to be incorporating into my studying, please let me know in the comments below. Remember, subscribe, leave a like, and thank you so much for watching.
Perfect.